Hey, you. It's forbidden to walk at night here without a light.
I love it. Hello, YouTube. It's the Covenator here.
Hey, where's your torch? You can't walk around here in the dark without a light.
And we are playing Kingdom Come Deliverance. And in true fashion, I'm getting harassed by the guards.
Only bandits creep around in the dark without a light. Where's your torch?
You're not going to give up, are you?
You must be up to no good sneaking around in the dark. Light a torch before the catchpoles see you.
Okay. I think I have a torch in here somewhere if I didn't sell it. Here it is. Are you happy now? I guess so. I love that. Just the sense of immersion in this game is just unreal. All the NPCs have their little lives. And yeah, we all know it's scripted, but you know, they actually, if you were to follow them around, you know, this nobleman right here, Sir Radzik, who has employed me, has his little routine. You know, he walks around town, goes to lunch, goes retire to his royal estate. These guards actually have shifts that they rotate in and out. And it's just something you don't see in a lot of games, single-player games. You know, developers will often take the lazy approach. You know, just things like having to equip a light during night. You know, I love that. These NPCs and just the way they've done it, it just makes the world feel alive.
Started counting out the coin there and then.
Just like that? What I heard about him, he's a right skinflint. And what did that have to say?
The NPCs actually, they talk to each other and react to each other. I guess this homeless guy here is just, that's where he sleeps. And oddly enough, his name is Adam, which is also my name in real life.
Greetings.
Lovely day to you.
Just to fill you in, if you haven't watched my previous videos, we are being employed by Sir Radzik to, and by the way, you know, we didn't start off as a hero, or, you know, this is a very different experience from other games where you start off, you know, trying to save the world. Now we're pretty much a peasant, and our parents have been killed. Our father was a blacksmith, and we are just making ourselves into the world. And the thing about this world is, it will just continue on with you or without you. So we need to do some training with Sir Bernard, and he's just outside of town, and even though I haven't been there yet, I know that because it's nighttime, he won't be there. Like I said, all the NPCs in the town have their own little lives. They have their own posts and their own jobs, and afterwards they go home. So probably not going to be able to do that one right now. We can do that in the morning. We also have this other quest. The town that we came from was pretty much burned to the ground, and the Miller has basically taken us in, and we have a debt that we have to pay. And he's kind of a shady kind of a character, so he's actually wanting us to get him a ring from a guy that's been executed and who's buried. So that's something we probably want to do during the nighttime, so we're going to give that a try.
I'm from Scarlet, good folk. You all know what happened there. Help your neighbor.
Now that's interesting. I actually recognize his voice. I wonder if that's the... It is! Kanish. This guy was giving me a really hard time. In fact, one of the very first quests I got was to have him pay back a debt that he owed my father. And he kicked my butt pretty good. things did not go well, and we ended up getting into a fight. But I ended up coming back with friends and getting what I needed from him. But it was basically nothing. It was like some hammer and some nails or something.
I wouldn't beg, good neighbors, but I'm reduced to this. I'm from Scarlet's and, well, you know.
So many...
I see you survived.
Aren't you observant?
That's right. You still owe me. That is so cool. That I just happened to run into him.
You still owe me. Don't think I've forgotten.
I don't owe you. I owe your father, and he's dead. So get out of here.
Interesting.
Do you really want to make me angry? Do you really think that's wise?
No, I don't. Fine. I owe you. And what am I supposed to do about it? Do you think you'll get anything from me? Look at what I've got. But maybe I could... Maybe I could tell you where you can find some money. If you forgive my debt, that is.
All right, then. Start talking.
No. First, I want you to swear you won't be demanding anything else from me.
And these choices have consequences. I mean...
Very well, then. Talk.
When we were running from Scarlet's, I heard something. I don't know who said it. It's a miracle I could even hear it in that chaos. Either way, somebody hid a lot of coin under a dovecote.
Under a dovecote? And that's it?
That's all I know. How many dovecots could there be in Scarlet's? If you've got the guts to go back there, you're bound to find it.
Fine. We'll see.
And that's a lot how this game works, because we ended up with the right dialogue options. I actually recognized him. We actually got a quest now. I have no idea what a dovecote is, but I guess we'll find out. So I guess we could go do that instead. But just to show you that this guy's got a routine, I'm going to follow him and see where he goes. He's homeless, so he probably doesn't have a place. But like I said, he gave me quite a bit of a hard time, so... I don't know, maybe we can steal from him. He's not carrying a light either, so I don't know what that's all about. Light. Everybody should be carrying a light, but maybe because he's poor and doesn't have anything. This is apparently where the poor people live. Where's he going? He's apparently contemplating something. Alright, let's do something here. I'll put my light out first. It's interesting, I got a knockout option. I don't think that kills him, but let's go ahead and do that, see what that does. I've never done that before. That was awesome. All right, let's loot. All right, being able to read is a rare skill, but in the end, you'll have to find someone who can teach you. That is awesome. I love how I'm a peasant. I'm a nobody. I can't even freaking read. Alright, before we get caught, let's get our torch back on. Don't mind me. let's take a look at what we got there. I know we can't read, but let me take a look at it. Let's see. Yeah, I pretty much can't make that out. I can study it, though. Okay, so that's another quest of something that we have to do. You can kind of make out that they've kind of have scrambled the words. Like, the first word is obviously the. So, I imagine it gets more legible the more skill you get. And the word kind of in the middle of the paragraph is Y. You know, it's W-Y-H and that. Why that. People. You know, you can make out certain words. That's so cool.
Hey.
Excuse me, sir. All right. So let's take a look at our map. And apparently I need to activate, I only have this other quest activated, so we need to do that first. I'll go ahead and turn those other ones off. Alright. So we are now leaving the town. And I don't have a horse yet or anything like that. And those indicators at the bottom of the screen, it's basically telling me that I'm tired, but I'm going to go ahead and push through, see if I can't get this quest done. See if I can make my way down here without breaking a leg. Looks like there's another little camp down here. And the nighttime is no joke in this game. I mean, if I didn't have this torch on, it would be pitch black. I wouldn't be able to see anything. In fact, let me do that just to really see. I can't see anything at all. And if we were wanting to sneak around, this is how we would do it. We have a little bit of illumination from the moon, but that's basically about it. And dogs are the medieval alarm systems. Back in the day. I really need my torch. I don't know if this is a town or just some dude's house, but I feel like I'm kind of intruding. Just trying to make my way towards the green marker. And right there's a dog. And it looks like we've gotten past him without waking up. Spoke too soon. And here's the thing. Those dogs will wake him up if they bark loudly enough. So you can see the kind of the lights on in there, so yeah, we need to leave like right now. There he is, right there. We are running away. I do not want to get in trouble with the law. I am supposed to access the gravesite, or, I mean, I've discovered the gallows. I guess this is his grave. I bet you I can find a spade in here. We're going to have to be sneaky about it. And, like, a lot of things, there's several different ways we could go about this. We could probably talk to him and tell him that we just want to get the ring off the guy, and I don't know, maybe he'd let us dig it up, or we can try and be sneaky, which is what we're doing right now, or thing is without a torch I can't really see all that well. Maybe we should wait till morning and talk to him. Let's see, can I take that axe? I know this is risky, but I'm going to turn on my torch a little bit, because I bet you there's a shovel or a spade or whatever I need somewhere inside there, so. I just gotta be careful not to get too close to the dogs. There's gotta be one here somewhere. Oh, wait a minute. Is that it? Looks like a shovel. Alright, we got the spade. Let's go grave robbing. Yeah, we probably don't want to be digging this grave up and drawing attention to ourselves. Alright, let's do this.
Christ wounds, what a fucking stink. How long have you been lying here? Nothing on the left hand. The right? Oh shit, there's nothing there either. Where the fuck is that ring? Oh, that stench makes me want to puke. Peshek will pay for this.
There is no ring. Yes, he will have something to say about it. So we have a fast travel option, and as you discover these fast travels, you can kind of use them so that you're not spending 80% of your time in the game just moving from one location to another. And I imagine once I get a horse, it'll be a lot faster too. So we're going to go ahead and fast travel, get some sleep, and talk to him about that. When during fast travel, you have an option of, you know, you may run into bandits, you may, you know, there's like a chance of a random encounter to happen. This is our home. Well, it's not really our home. We're squatting here, but it'll do for the time being. I don't know if this game has housing in it, but or it may be part of an expansion, maybe. We obviously can't talk to him now. He's asleep. And this is another part of the game where you have to keep all these numbers up. So you notice that my energy, you know, I was really tired. My energy's low. So we have to eat. But sleeping. Here, let's sleep until about 3 as it is like 3 in the morning. That'll get our energy level up to almost 100%. Yeah, we'll sleep till then. And then we'll go, we'll talk to him about the ring. We'll do some training, that sort of thing. But we are going to be hungry when we wake up, that's for sure. You could see those numbers drop and change. And I'm sure the comfort is some sort of multiplier, which matters. First things first, we're going to get some breakfast and talk to Teresa here.
Look at the state you're in.
I'm not sure what she meant about that. I mean, it's not like I'm covered in blood or anything, but appearance does matter in this game.
What are you up to? How would you like to, I don't know, come for a walk?
A walk? I'd like that very much, but I can't right now, Hal. Give me some time to settle in, will you?
If that's what you want.
It's not you, Hal. It's just this isn't a good time.
We are pretty hungry. I'd like to eat, but apparently she's messing with it, so we'll have to wait. Can go talk to the miller about him wanting us to get that ring that we couldn't get. Maybe we can get some breakfast now. Well, apparently not. Maybe we have to drop something in the pot to eat it. And where is the miller? What are you doing up there? Push me off. Okay. Well, I can't talk to him, and I can't use the ladder, and he is not wanting to move, so we may have to come back and talk to him later. So I think what we're going to do is we are in desperate need of some training, so we're going to go get that done. And I'm really looking forward to it because I suck so bad. And combat is a big part of this game, so we need to get all that figured out. If you're wondering what this little place is in front of us, this is a bathhouse where you can clean, launder your clothes. And again, that all affects your appearance and how NPCs react to you. As we don't have a lot of money, we're going to push on. Hello, sir. Good day to you. You know, I wonder if I can fast travel there. I didn't even look. Yes, I can. But you know what? We have so many unexplored places. Let's actually walk through the town and see if we can't open all these up, since we really haven't explored much. The landscape and everything is just absolutely stunning. From what I understand, this is actually a accurate I don't know if they, like, you know, used, I think they used, like, Google Maps or something, and they actually got accurate geography of the terrain and everything, and, this is about as real to the times as it gets.
Dear people, don't leave a poor woman to starve. Sigismund took everything I had, the godless beast. Have some compassion.
Did you find out what actually happened?
What do I know? The lords are at each other's throats, but it's us that has to suffer for it. Same as always. I reckon they was after the silver mines, wasn't they?
How does life in Rat-Eye suit you?
It'd be fine if we didn't have to sleep in hovels and beg for alms. And the bailiff is always on our backs, the bastard. But what can we do? We've got nowhere else to go.
Take care.
Well, I don't know how to give them money. Yeah, not sure how to do that. Pressing onward, we have training to do.
Kettles for water, baskets for goods, and torches for the night. I had it all.
Hear ye, good people. Vegetables! Fresh vegetables!
The people, come up close and have a smell! Fresh bread, and pour yourself a bit of fresh milk.
He shall enter therein.
My home, my family, my livelihood. Be merciful, good people.
Might as well open all these up so we can see what they are. The NPCs can apparently give them money, but I can't. I don't know what the stars mean. Oh, quest tipster, okay. Hopefully Sir Bernard is here and not out to lunch. Like I said, they have their own routine, so... And if you're wondering about all these codex entries, you can actually go and read them. I have yet to do that. But... there's quite a few, and these stars, I think, indicate that I haven't read any, or that they're new. I mean, there's just tons of information.
Good day to you. What do you need?
I'm here for training.
Yes, hear that boy Sir Radzik sent.
I'm not a boy.
That's for me to decide. Right now, boy is exactly what you seem. And because you've never held a sword in your hand before, we'll start with something simple.
Very well.
Come with me and listen closely. I don't want to be repeating myself.
Take care now. So let's see what you're made of. Hold it properly and keep moving. Never stand still when your life depends on it. Right, good. Now, try attacking. You've got to put your back into a good slash. No use waving the sword around like you're swatting flies. Go into the attack with your whole body. Try slashing from various sides to get used to it. Not bad. Good. Nice. Not bad. Well done. That pointy tip isn't for decoration. Try stabbing me with it a few times. Good. All right.
Move quickly.
Not bad. That will do. Slashing, stabbing, and movement are the foundations that you build everything else on. Now, let's try something more complicated. One strike, I can simply fend off. You mustn't give your opponent time to react. String your strikes together. As soon as you finish one, begin another. Strike, strike, strike.
Move quickly.
Okay, let's give this a shot.
That's it. I don't have all day, boy. Nice. Well done. Now let's see how you do with defense. It's not hard to block a basic strike. Just watch out. Move your sword into the path of the blow.
Wrong!
Very good! Very good! No, that's not it! Wrong! Very good! Well done.
Very well then. Let's see what you're made of, lad. Come at me and don't hold back.
I'm noticing that as I... Oh.
Ow.
See, I lure you, then attack unexpectedly.
This guy's kicking my butt.
Yeah.
Good hit.
I cannot get the blocks down.
Good strike.
Ow.
Fine. That's enough. I have my work cut out, it seems.
No kidding.
Let's try something more advanced. When in combat, keep an eye on the space between you and your opponent. That is your space. Try to attack from the side the opponent will find harder to block in time. If I'm holding the sword raised up, do an uppercut. My sword is low, lunge. Let's try it. You strike a few times at the side where I'm not holding my sword.
Nice!
No, that's not like that! Well done. That's it! Good. All
right. Right, lesson two. Everything you've learned about blocking is wrong. When I cover, I can simply fend off your blows with my sword and gain control of the space between us. It's better not to control just the space, but actually your opponent's weapon. Attack, and I'll show you.
All right, that will do.
Now you. The trick is to stay in your stance. As soon as I start to attack, you block. The move knocks the blade aside.
Ah. No, not like that. You mustn't hold the sword there.
Okay, I gotta wait for it to turn green.
Again. That's it. Nice. That's it. Well done. Good. Right, now we'll try it a little faster. Concentrate and block just at the moment I start attacking. I'll strike you from above each time so you can see it well. Well done.
Ow.
Well done.
This doesn't seem any fast.
Nice.
Ow.
Good. Now let's try it at full speed. You probably won't succeed,
okay.
But that's normal at the start. You must train. Let's go.
Train.
Ow.
Wait a while, Henry. Greetings, Sir Hans. What brings you here?
I was on my way when I noticed that you're entertaining Sir Radzig's esteemed guest. Not the same as holding a hammer, is it, blacksmith?
It's Sir Radzig's orders.
I know. I'm actually here to train at the archery range. My hand's grown heavy lately. You don't mind, do you, Bernard?
Not at all, my lord.
Good day to you, blacksmith's boy. Try not to hurt yourself.
Oh, I hate him.
Where did we finish? Yeah, leading the opponent where you want him. There's one more way to evade a strike. You simply step aside, attack, and I'll show you.
I don't have all day, boy.
All right, try it. It's important not to move too soon. I'll see where you're going and hit you. If the same will happen if you move too late. I'll attack slowly now. As you see me, raise the weapon, jump aside. It'll throw the opponent off a bit, and there's your chance.
Not bad.
Ow.
Wrong. Again. Well done. Good.
Fine. Now try it a little quicker. Try and get used to the rhythm. Never take your eyes off your opponent. You'll see a strike before it's even properly started.
Good. All right.
Ow.
Well done.
And the last thing for today, a trick. You raise the sword to force your opponent to block, but then change the direction of the attack at the last moment, and the opponent won't even know what hit him. Try it. Draw back the weapon, then change the attack zone and strike, so I don't have time to react.
Very good. Wrong, damn it! Good. Not bad. Wrong. Good. Nice. Well now, that wasn't too bad. Maybe we'll make a soldier of you after all. But don't get cocky. You have to train hard and persistently. You might have talent, but talent alone won't do. Practice. Don't leave yet. Sir Radzig also wanted me to teach you archery. Come with me.
Well, I hope that I can do that over and over again. I was noticing like things like strength and defense and all that was going up as I was training, so that may be a thing that I need to do. It's just, and I won't record all of that, but I plan to do a lot of training, and I especially want to get good at archery. But from what I understand, it's pretty hard to do. You don't get an aiming pip. You know, I have that gold little pip in the center of my screen. When you're using a bow, that kind of goes away. So it takes a lot of practice and a lot of getting used to. Which I'm okay with.
But I'm reduced to this. I'm from Scarlet's and... well, you know.
Make up your mind where you're going, dude.
Help your neighbor.
Let's see then. Take this bow, go and stand in position over there, and we can start. And another thing, put on this arm guard. Without it, you could flay your forearm with a bowstring, so be sure to wear it.
Thank you, Captain.
Save the thanks, and get in position.
I feel
now concentrate.
Hungry.
A bow ain't exactly the weapon of choice of a knight, but it can come in very handy. You've got two bandits coming at you from a distance. You shoot one in the eye, drop your bow, and draw your sword on the other. Emperor Charles, God rest him, encouraged his subjects to learn archery. He even organized contests in Prague. But you wouldn't have gotten far there. You're holding the thing like a piece of firewood. But enough talk. There's the target. Try and hit it. Draw the bow, aim, and release. Try to get a feel for the rhythm. Inhale on the draw. Hold your
there
bow
we go.
For a moment, and then release the string. No jerky movement. Just let the string slide out of your fingers, as if you were about to draw it back more. It's all one movement, the arrow aiming at the target and flying at it. Shoot away. What you have there is a training bow. The arrow drops quickly. Once you've trained a bit, you can get yourself a better one, and then those arrows will fly so fast you won't see them. Don't forget the arm guard.
I'm so tempted to shoot him.
Well, that was awful. I didn't imagine a village yokel like you would have much skill, but you failed to meet even my low expectations.
I thought that was alright. What are you talking about?
Why are you wasting your time?
I hit the target.
Nothing will come of him anyway, and at the first sign of trouble, he'll run away like any other cowardly peasant.
Oh.
After all, he's done it before.
Oh.
What did you say?
Calm down, boy. Keep in mind who you're talking to.
The braggart who was born with a silver spoon in his mouth.
You've really done it. You'll go to the stocks for that.
Calm yourself, Sir Bernard. If the blacksmith boy feels he can prove himself, then let him try. Do you think you can beat me? Well?
Anytime.
Very well. If you defeat me, I'll give you my bow. If you lose, you'll have to pay up. Do you even have any coin?
I don't have enough.
Then you'll owe me or work it off. Let's get to it.
He's going down.
Didn't expect that. Probably just wasn't your day, sir.
I told you I have a heavy hand, ever since I fell off that horse during the last hunt. What are you grinning about, boy?
Give me the bow, bitch!
A little payback. How about a sword fight at the arena?
If you like.
Sir Hans, is this necessary? Hanish has already had words about you fighting with your subjects. He explicitly told me.
I know what he told you. You can just tell him I didn't listen to you. So what's it going to be, blacksmith?
If we must.
Excellent. Then let's go.
And I can't save. Ugh. All right. Let's do this. No pressure. I want to beat him so bad, though. We'll see how this goes.
You are for it.
I'm hanging.
I'm going to enjoy it. Here. Yeah.
Take that! Yeah!
Ow!
You're just lucky. Oh dear, did that hurt? Bollocks!
You got the better of me this time, blacksmith. I must be having an off day.
Are you all right, sir?
Don't worry your mangy head about me, peasant. We'll see each other again soon enough. You can keep my bow. Its best years are behind it anyway.
That was awesome.
You better hope his lordship hasn't taken it badly.
Love it.
I hope he has.
Watch it, boy. A few of my men have won fights against him before and never had a problem. But you could be the first. Now go to the rat house. The bailiff's waiting for you there.
All right, Captain.
All right, that's going to do it for this episode. If you want to see more, be sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.